Hi dear all, today I am sharing a video on the congenital hypothyroidism. Why this topic is important? Because the congenital hypothyroidism is the most common preventable cause of mental retardation. That is, if you identify timely the congenital hypothyroidism and you treat it well, then you can prevent the child from developing the intellectual disability. Another thing, if we see what is the most common cause of congenital hypothyroidism, that is thyroid dysgenesis. Why it is occurring? Because there is dysgenesis of the thyroid gland that occurs in 75% of the children. Then another question you may get in pre-PG is like syndrome associated with congenital hypothyroidism. One of them is Pendred syndrome that occurs because of the mutation in the Pendrin gene, and there occurs the error in the iodine transport that leads to the congenital hypothyroidism along with the deafness. Another thing, the genes commonly associated with congenital hypothyroidism are TSHR, TSHP, PAX8, and also if we discuss the clinical features of congenital hypothyroidism, you can remember it with the letters PH. Later we will be discussing about the clinical features in detail. Now, what is the etiology of the congenital hypothyroidism? Why it is occurring? So there may be thyroid dysgenesis. So thyroid dysgenesis has emerged as the most common cause of the congenital hypothyroidism, which is responsible for 75% of all the cases. There may occur complete agenesis of the thyroid gland, there may be partial agenesis, or there may be ectopic thyroid. Another thing we can get is thyroid dyshomogenesis, means there is some biosynthetic defect that may occur in the iodine transport or peroxidation or thyroglobulin synthesis or deiodination, all that can lead to the hypothyroidism. So there can be functional defect. Then another thing you may get is there may be transient congenital hypothyroidism, which may occur following the transplacental passage of the TSH receptor blocking antibodies from the mother to the baby. Also, if there is ingestion of the antithyroid drugs like amiodarone by the mother, that can lead to the congenital hypothyroidism in the child. Now, if we discuss the clinical features of congenital hypothyroidism, the very first thing we need to remember is we can remember it with the letters PH. So CH, that is congenital hypothyroidism, can be remembered with the help of the PH. P, certain clinical features we can remember with the help of the P, and the rest of the features we can remember with the H. Now, the very first thing, there are very few features which you can identify in the neonatal period. Slowly as the child gets elder, so these clinical features become prominent with increasing age. So another thing, another problem is that till the time you may identify with the help of the clinical features, the child may have already landed into the intellectual disability and poor brain growth. So to prevent that, we need the neonatal screening. That is why there is a concept of doing the neonatal screening for the congenital hypothyroidism. Now we can see the clinical features. First thing is they become prominent with the increasing age. Another thing you may get is posterior fontanelle is open. In the baby with the congenital hypothyroidism, there may be palar, there may be protruding tongue that occurs because of the large tongue. Also, there may be protruding umbilicus that occur because of the umbilical hernia. The child may have the puffy eyes. The child may have edematous facies. Also, the child may present with the prolonged jaundice. So, one of the reason for the prolonged jaundice is congenital hypothyroidism, other than the UTI and other reasons. Now, if we talk of H, so certain features which we can remember with the help of the letter H are hoarse cry. The cry of the newborn will be hoarse. Another thing you will get is hypotonia, hypothermia, that is cold and dry skin will be there. Also heart stool. So constipation is one of the features of congenital hypothyroidism. Now there are certain clues while you take a history in a child with congenital hypothyroidism, you can get towards some causes. Like in maternal history, if you get that there is ingestion of the antithyroid drugs, or if the mother is having certain thyroid disease, so that can point towards the transient congenital hypothyroidism that may have occurred because either due to the passage of the antibodies or due to the intake of the antithyroid drugs. Another thing, if the family history of hypothyroidism is positive, that suggests that dyshomogenesis as the cause of the congenital hypothyroidism. Then if they are residing in the iodine deficient area, so iodine deficiency may be the reason. Another thing, if there is presence of the goiter, so we can think of the dyshomogenesis or intake of the antithyroid drug by the mother. Also, if there is hypoglycemia, micropenis or midline defect, that points towards the secondary cause of the congenital hypothyroidism that occurs because either in the defect of the hypothalamus or pituitary, that leads to the hypothyroidism. So if there are midline defects along with the other features that point towards the central cause of the congenital hypothyroidism. Now, how to approach a child with congenital hypothyroidism? So you have already seen the clinical features, important points which we have to take in the history. Now, if we talk of the investigation, if suppose the child is presenting with the high TSH, so TSH is high, then you are going to do his thyroid scan. When you do the thyroid scan, if there is no uptake, or if there is ectopic uptake, or there is increased uptake. If there is ectopic uptake, the thing is very straight that the child is having ectopic thyroid. If there is increased uptake, that suggests there is dyshomogenesis. But if there is no uptake, then we need to go for the ultrasonography. If on ultrasonography there is no thyroid gland visible, that suggests there is thyroid agenesis. But if the thyroid is normal, still the uptake is not there, that suggests that there are antibodies, there may be antibodies against the TSH receptor. Then we will go for the test of antibodies against the TSH receptor. If the antibodies are positive, that suggests that maternal antibodies are there for the TSH receptor. Or if the negative, then we need to think of the iodine transporter defect or TSH receptor defect. So this is the way we are going to proceed. So very first thing, high TSH is there, then we will go for thyroid scan. Thyroid scan se hum agenesis, ectopic, or agar increased uptake hai to dyshomogenesis sochenge. Agar uptake nahi hai, then we need to see via ultrasonography. Agar gland hi nahi hai, that suggests ki thyroid agenesis hai. Agar normal thyroid gland hai, that suggests ki humko antibody test ke liye jana chahiye. Aur antibody test agar positive hai, that means ki maternal antibodies gayi against the TSH receptor. Agar antibody test negative hai, matlab transporter mein gadbadi hai ya phir TSH receptor mein gadbadi hai, isliye uptake nahi ho raha hai. So this is the way we will proceed in the child with congenital hypothyroidism. Now if we talk of the thyroid replacement, अभी हमको डायग्नोसिस बन गया है कॉन्जेनेटल हाइपोथायरॉइडिज्म का. व्हाट वी नीड टू डू इज़ वी नीड टू ट्रीट. एंड द वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट थिंग इज़ कि जब भी हमारे पास कॉन्जेनेटल हाइपोथायरॉइडिज्म का बच्चा है, हमने आइडेंटिफाई कर लिया है कि है, हमको जल्दी से जल्दी ट्रीट करना है ताकि हम प्रिवेंट कर सकें इंटेलेक्चुअल डिसेबिलिटी और बाकी न्यूरोलॉजिकल फीचर्स को. तो उसके लिए वी नीड टू गिव द थायरॉयड रिप्लेसमेंट. अब दो रीजंस आए, या तो प्राइमरी कॉन्जेनेटल हाइपोथायरॉइडिज्म होगा या सेकेंडरी होगा. तो प्राइमरी कॉजेज जो थायरॉयड से ही रिलेटेड हैं, जिसमें कि थायरॉयड डिसजेनेसिस है या dyshormogenesis है, all that. Secondary में it is occurring because of the hypothalamus या pituitary. तो जो secondary है hypothalamus या pituitary की वजह से जिसमें हो रहा है, तो उसमें thyroid के साथ साथ हमको adrenal deficiency भी होगी. तो उसमें हमने thyroid की replacement से पहले adrenal insufficiency के लिए cortisol replacement करना है. जबकि जो हमारे primary causes है, जो हमारा most common causes है, suppose thyroid dysgenesis है, उस situation में हमको एल्ट्रॉक्सिन ही स्टार्ट करना है. विद द डोज हम थायरॉक्सिन का स्टार्ट करेंगे एट द इनिशियल डोज ऑफ 10 टू 15 माइक्रोग्राम पर केजी पर डे. इफ इट इज द न्यूनेटल पीरियड, इफ इट इज 1 to 6 मंथ्स, देन वी आर गोइंग टू स्टार्ट विद द 6 to 10 माइक्रोग्राम पर केजी पर डे. और ये हम एम्प्टी स्टमक मॉर्निंग में देते हैं. देन थायरॉयड डोज को, थायरॉक्सिन का जो डोज है, हम उसको धीरे धीरे एडजस्ट करेंगे. हमको जो T4 के फ्री T4 का लेवल है, वो हमको अपर नॉर्मल रेंज में सेट करना है. देन this is the way we will proceed. Now screening. Screening is another very important point जिसमें आपको दो तीन चीज़ें पता होना चाहिए. एक तो screening कब करनी है. तो screening usually हम करते हैं 2 to 4 days के बीच में, मतलब 48 hours के बाद आप newborn period में करोगे. screening क्यों important है, क्योंकि clinical features बहुत slowly develop करते हैं. जब तक आप identify करोगे, that may be late. तो child में have already landed into the intellectual disability. तो उसको prevent करने के लिए you do the newborn period में ही screening करते हैं हम. देन स्क्रीनिंग हमको विनस ब्लड सैंपल से करते हैं, 48 hours के बाद करते हैं. और जो मैक्सिमम इंस्टीट्यूट जो स्ट्रैटेजी यूज़ करते हैं कि हम TSH के लिए जाते हैं पहले, तो यू विल स्क्रीन विद द हेल्प ऑफ द TSH. और आपने एक बार TSH से स्क्रीन कर लिया, अगर TSH जो है उसके हायर लेवल्स हैं, वो कट ऑफ के क्रॉस आ रहे हैं, देन वी विल गो फॉर दी T4 एंड फर्दर इन्वेस्टिगेशन. सो दिस इज द वे वी प्रोसीड फॉर दी कॉन्जेनाइटल हाइपोथायरॉइडिज्म.